This is Jacob.
No. Take your shoes off, brother. Come on. You don't need it. He's not ashamed of the gospel. Come on, let's do this. You got anything in your pockets? Oh, yeah. Come on now. Oh, hey, everyone turn around. I'm moving. You didn't see that dip. Don't judge. Don't judge. Sit down, brother. Let's take a moment. Let's pray for Jacob. Will you guys join in that? Lord, I thank you for this beautiful man. I thank you, Lord, that you've opened up his heart to the truth of his sinfulness and his need for a Savior. I thank you, Lord, that you've opened up his heart not only to the need of a Savior, but to the need of the right Savior, the only Savior, and that is Jesus Christ. Lord, I know that even today, the spiritual powers of the dark world have been battling for his obedience, and he has broke through that, and he's come today to be obedient to you. Lord, you have fought a battle for him, and you have won, yes, yet again. Lord, I pray the same thing, that would happen all the days of his life, that you would go to bat for him, you'd go to battle for him, that he would win battles not because of his own strength, his own ingenuity, his own creativity or wisdom, but Lord, that you would go to fight for him and you would win. Just like you did in the scriptures when the nation of Israel was at war and they were outnumbered, Lord, you came and you confused the enemy. They started killing themselves. You won the battle for them. And Lord, you did that for him today, and I pray you'd continue to do that all the days of his life. Lord, I pray that your Holy Spirit would pierce his heart in many ways, that he would wake him up to the reality of who you are, that he would follow you mightily, he would follow you passionately. That Lord, his spirit for you, his excitement, his enthusiasm for you would be lasting and deep and loving, would be hot all the days of his life. Let him start this life right now praising you. Let him end this life on this earth with his hands held high, praising the creator of the universe. In Jesus' name, Jacob, who's your one and only Lord and Savior? Oh, that's awesome. Based on that confession, I now bury you with Christ. You'll be raised to new life because you trusted in the mighty power of God that raised Christ from the dead. I baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Amen.